Some of the best-known figures in London councils face the axe if the report is implemented. They include Haringey's leader, Bernie Grant, who's a race advisor in Newham, Brent's leader, Merle Amory, who works for the Inner London Education Authority, and Patrick Kerdikara, Camden's social services director, who's a Hackney councillor. The man behind the report is David Widdicombe, QC. He's aiming to limit what he calls the abuse of power in local government.
We've found that local government is reasonably healthy, but there's a lot of uncertainties developed due to this increased politicisation. There's party politics is much more active than it has been, and the gap between the parties is greater than it has been. So a lot of the existing rules and conventions have come under strain.
For some, the ban amounts to an ultimatum. If you stay a councillor, you'll lose your job. This Southwark councillor also has a job with the London Residuary Body.
This verdict is a bit like saying that milkmen shouldn't be members of the Milk Marketing Board, or that people who work for factories shouldn't take part in deciding how those should be run. I think it's a nonsense.
It must be wrong to ban people just because of the job they do from either voting, canvassing or belonging to a political party. That is attacking democracy.
Of the London councillors affected, the vast majority, about 100, are Labour members.
Has it escaped your attention that the recommendations would hurt your opponents more than they would hurt your own party?
I wouldn't dream of putting that sort of interpretation on it after a quick reading and not a deep study. But I don't think that it may be a coincidence that our opponents appear to have been the ones who have been engaging in the practices which caused the Committee of Inquiry to be set up in the first case.
The report contains dozens of other recommendations for changing the way our town halls work. Amongst them, that the tuppenny rate which councils can spend on things like community projects and grants should be doubled. That the council watchdog, the Ombudsman, should have greater powers, including investigating and prosecuting local authorities. And a restriction on councils co-opting non-elected members to vote on committees. The government say before any law is introduced to Parliament, there'll be wide discussion and consultation. Rita Carter, Thames News.